Hey guys, what's up? Today I'm gonna talk about emulators. Okay, emulators are so nice. I mean, you can play all the games, you know, all the games from the consoles, you know, early consoles, not the new ones, early ones like PS1, PS2, Nintendo DS, Nintendo 64. Game Boy Advance, Game Boy Color, Nintendo Entertainment System, which is called NES, and Super NES. I mean, you can play even Sega Genesis, okay? You can play all those games on your PC thanks to all the emulators, okay? And there are so much more to come, okay, in 2016. There's this video I saw 2 or 3 weeks ago about the upcoming new emulators, okay? Like for example, there is this one for playing PS3 games on your PC, which is called RPCS3, which is making tremendous development now. You know, it has progressed immensely since the past few months. The developers are playing, you know, are able to play quite a few games on the emulator in great speed. So it would take at least one more year to, you know, refine the whole thing, to polish it, to make it more playable. So there is this so this one is called RPCS3, which can play PS3 games on your PC. Another one is called XQEMU. Okay, why can't these people name their emulators, you know, in a very— why can't these developers give their emulators a nice name, you know, nice easy name? Anyway, so this one is called XQEMU, which will enable you to play the first Xbox games, okay, the first console in the Xbox series. So you can play all the Xbox games via this emulator on your PC. Another one is called Xenia, or it is XENIA. Xenia emulator. By this emulator you can play Xbox 360 games, okay? Can you believe it? Xbox 360 games on your PC. And they're all, you know, these emulators are all working, but they're not working up to the mark, okay? They are lagging and stuff, but they are still, you know, development has been going on. It's going well. The development is going well, okay? It would take 1 or 2 years to refine it. And another one is called Citra 3DS emulator, okay? This emulator will let you play Nintendo 3DS, the new handheld console games, on your PC, okay? And there's another one emulator for playing Wii U games on your PC. There's already an emulator called Dolphin emulator to play the Wii games and GameCube games on your PC, but there is also an emulator which is— I forgot the name of that emulator, but there is the development is going on that emulator, which will enable you to play Wii U games on your PC, okay? So there's that. You know, I'm still waiting for a PS Vita emulator, because there are lots of RPGs on the PS Vita, and it would be amazing if someone comes up with a PS Vita emulator soon, okay? There's already a PSP emulator called PPSSPP, which is awesome, okay? I'm playing Persona 3 right now on PPSSPP, and there's no lag, there's no glitch, nothing, okay? It's awesome. So PPSSPP is great for playing PSP games on your PC, okay? So I'll keep you all posted on more news about Xenia, XQEMU, RPCS3, Citra, and that Wii U emulator, okay? I'll keep you all posted. Okay, now I want to talk about this plethora of this huge dump of early access survival games on Steam. Do you think that all of them will ever come out of early access? Do you ever think that? I mean, I don't think all those games will come out of early access. Not each of them. I think maybe very few might come out of early access. I'm still waiting for Ark Survival Evolved to come out of early access. Okay. I don't think Subnautica would ever come out. I don't think DayZ would ever come out of early access, and even Stranded Deep and Forest. I think Forest would come out of early access, but Stranded Deep, I'm not so sure. So you know, there are so many early access survival games on Steam. Okay, I don't think all of them would come out of early access. That's how it happens, you know. For example, if there are like 100 games in early access, only 20 or 15 games come out of early access. Okay, only 15 or 16 games come out in full release state. The rest are all in early access, which is really sad. Okay, because in early access, it's like it has become sort of like a scam. You know, because people, you have to pay to the company to be a play tester, okay, to be a beta tester. In early days, the companies used to pay you to test their games, but now in this early access thing, you have to pay the company and buy that early access unfinished game from them and then play it, and if you find any bugs and stuff, you just comment it on the Steam page and then they will fix those bugs, and then you have to again, and more people will going to buy that unfinished game, and then more people will play it. They will see if there are any more bugs, and then if there are any bugs, they are going to post, they are going to write about it in the comments. The developers would correct those bugs. Okay, they'll fix those bugs. But you know, a lot of times what happens is the developers stop fixing the bugs. Okay, they stop updating the game and they stop being active. They suddenly just abandon all the work on the early access games. In that moment, you know, the people feel cheated. Okay, obviously they will feel cheated because they bought that early access game, they played it, now they're waiting for the full finished game. Okay, but they're not getting it. They will not get it because the devs have abandoned the game. So that's really a sad thing. A lot of games, you know, a lot of games have seen this. You know, a lot of this thing has happened to a lot of games. Okay, for example, there's this game called Stomping Feet. Okay, it's another, I think Stomping Land, sorry. Please correct my mistake if you can. I read about this game a long time back. I even played it on my friend's PC. It was an early access dinosaur survival game, something like that. It was like Ark Evolved, not that cool as Ark, but it was like that, you know. It had dinosaurs, survival aspects and all that shit. So yeah, so it didn't get completed. Okay, the developers abandoned that game. So you know, it's really sad, you know, if these things happen. So what I want to say is, please don't buy early access games. Okay, let the game finish. Only buy completed finished games. Okay, if the devs want money for finishing their game, just donate it on their PayPal. Okay, but don't buy the game, you know, just and then complain about it, and you know, just buy the full game. Always buy full games. So take care.